It's the Lord's Day that we can come together in the name of Lord Jesus Christ to worship you. And worship you is from the day we believe in Lord Jesus Christ till the day that God will call us back. And not only that, in the heavenly places we will also worship you. And as we worship you, we want to learn from your word, because your word is the living word. And your word gives us wisdom and understanding, so that we may know how to live a life that is pleasing unto you on earth. And that many people, through your word, will be blessed. 父神上帝，我们谢谢你， 让我们从信主的时候都开始敬拜你。 我们敬拜你是一生一世， 而且敬拜不只是在地上， 将来在天上我们也要 敬拜侍奉你，上帝啊，当我们敬拜你的时候，我们求主你帮助，让你的仆人能够传讲神你的话语，以及你的话语成为我们的力量、我们的帮助、我们的聪明和我们的智慧。所以，我们把今天早上这个线上的崇拜交托在你的手中，求上帝你的灵带领。祷告，奉主耶稣基督的名求，阿门。
弟兄们平安。Peace
be unto you, brothers and sisters in Christ.
今天和大家分享的信息是信心的定义与例证。I
would like to share the definition and illustration of our faith.
我们先看一段经文。Let
us look at a portion of scripture.
希伯来书第十一章一到十九节。
Hebrews chapter 1 verse 1 to 19.
希伯来书十一章一到十九节。
Hebrews chapter 1 verse 1 to 19.
那么，第一节，信就是所望，自是实底，是未见之事确据。Now
man is being sure of what we hope for and certain of what we do not see.
古人在这信上得了美好的证据。This
is what the ancients were commended for.
我们一个信就知道，诸世界是借神的话造成的，这样所看见的，并不是从显然之物造出来的。
By faith we understand that the universe was formed at God's command, so that what is seen was not made out of what was visible.
亚伯因着献祭与神比该隐所献的更美，因此便得了称义的见证，就是神指他做不作的见证，他虽死了，却因之信仍旧说话。
By faith Abel offered God a better sacrifice than Cain did. By faith he was commended as a righteous man when God spoke well of his offerings. And by faith he still speaks even though he is dead.
以诺一个信被接去，不知见死，人也找不着他，因为神已经把他接去了，只是他被接去以前，已经得了神喜悦他的凭证。By
faith Enoch was taken from this life so that he did not experience death. He could not be found because God had taken him away. For before he was taken, he was commended as one who pleased God.
并且人非有信就不能得神的喜悦，因为到神面前来的人必须信有神，且信他赏赐那信有他的人。
Verse 6, and without faith it is impossible to please God, because anyone who comes to him must believe that he exists, and that he rewards those who earnestly seek him.
若因着信，既蒙神指示他未见的事，动了敬畏的心，预备了一方舟，使他全家得救，因此就定了那时代的罪，自己也承受了那从信而来的义。By
faith Noah, when warned about things not yet seen, in holy fear built an ark to save his family. By his faith he condemned the world and became heir of the righteousness that comes by faith.
第八节，亚伯拉罕就信，临终的时候就遵命就去，往将来要得为业的地方去。出去时候还不知往哪里去。By
faith Abraham, when called to go to a place he could later receive as inheritance, obeyed and went, even though he did not know where he was going.
因着信就在所应许之地做客，好像在异地居住帐篷，与那同盟一个应许的以撒、雅各一样。
By faith he made his home in a promised land like a stranger in a foreign country. He lived in tents as did Isaac and Jacob, who were heirs with him of the same promise. For he was looking forward to the city with foundation whose architect and builder is God.
也就是拉撒连撒拉自己虽然过了生育的岁数还能怀孕，因他以为那应许的他的是可信的。
By faith Abraham, though he was past of age and Sarah herself was barren, was enabled to become a father because he considered himself faithful who had made the promise.
所以从一个放过一时的人就生出子孙，如同天上星那么众多，海边的沙那么无数。
And so from this one man, and he was as good as dead, came descendants as numerous as the stars in the sky, and as countless as the sand on the seashore.
十三节，这些人都是存着心里死的，并没有得着所应许的，却从远处望见，且欢喜迎接，又承认自己在世上是客旅，是寄居的。
All these people were still living by faith when they died. They did not receive the things promised.They only saw them and welcomed them from a distance, and they admitted that they were aliens and strangers on earth.
说这样话的人是表明自己要找一个家乡。
People who say such things shows that they are looking for a country of their own.
他们若想念所离开的家乡，还有可以回去的机会。
If they have been thinking of the country they left, they would have opportunity to return.
他们却羡慕一个更美的家乡，就是在天上的。所以被称为他们的神并不以为耻，因为他已经给他们预备了一座城。
Instead they were longing for a better country, a heavenly one. Therefore God is not ashamed to be called God, for he has prepared a city for them.
亚伯拉罕的信就是被试验的时候就把以撒献上，这便是那喜欢领受应许的将自己独生的儿子献上。
By faith Abraham, when God tested himOffered Isaac as a sacrifice. He who had received the promises was about to sacrifice his one and only son.
论到这子，曾有话说，从以撒生的才要称为你的后裔。
Even though God had said to him, it is to Isaac that your offspring will be reckoned.
他以为神还叫能叫人从死里复活，他也盼活从死中得回他的儿子来。
Abraham reasoned that God could raise the dead, and figuratively speaking, he did receive Isaac back from death.
弟兄们，如果你熟悉希伯来书的话
，If you are familiar with the book of Hebrew,
你会发现到希伯来书第十一章都在讨论有关信心的问题。
And you realize that Hebrews chapter 11 talks about faith of the saints.
希伯来书从亚伯开始讲起，一直说到先知这个的撒母耳。
And it begins with Abel, and then it ends with Samuel.
都集中在这个信心的这个课题上。
And it's focused on the topic of faith.
大家特别注意的是
，But what we should observe is that
希伯来书所讲到的信心是指对上帝要有信心。
And it talks about we must have faith in God.
那么信心是什么呢
？So what is faith?
希伯来书第十一章第一节就告诉我们说，信就是所望之事的实底，是未见之事的确据。
So verse 1 says, now faith is being sure of what we hope for, and certain of what we do not see.
所望之事实底，实底是什么意思呢
？So faith is being sure of what we hope for, and certain of what we do not see. What does it mean?
这个实底意思就是非常清楚，也可以确定的。
So it is.Very sure and confidence.
这个实底的词在古代的时候呢，是用在这个商业 A、B 双方签订契约时用的字眼。
So this surety is used is a business contract between a person and another person.
所以双方在该契约上签名的时候，表示确实有这个的买卖。
So when both parties sign this contract, then this.Contract is valid.
希伯来书用这个确底这个字呢，就是表明这一点了。
So when the book of Hebrew use this word, being sure, it says about this.
比如说，信心不是一个幻想。
So it's not an imagination.
而是知道所将来盼望的事是实在在，是确存在的。
So it's something that is truly sure and it exists.
信心也是未见之事的确据。
So faith is certain of what we do not see.
所以信心呢，不是凭眼看见的。
So it's not by what is being seen by us.
眼看见的不叫信心，眼看不见就信的就叫信心。
So what we see is not faith, but what we are able, what we do not see is what we call faith.
So 本来是我们对于这个眼未所见或不能见的事，觉得像亲眼看见一样。
So what we do not see is like what we will see in the future.
所以呢，信心是不需要凭证，而且它本身就是未见之事的确据。
So faith is do not need evidence, but there is a surety that will come about.
好的，第二节，古人在这信上得了美好的证据。
What's good is what the ancients were commended for.
所以谈信心呢，不是只是谈这个事物，而是谈人与上帝之间的关系。
So when we talk about faith, it's not about material thing, but about our relationship with God.
对，现在古人以这个古代信仰的前辈为例子，讲出这个信心的。So
the ancient is commended for what? For their faith.
这些古人他们都得了神的喜悦，是因为他们对神有绝对的信心。
And these ancient people, they please God because they have faith in God.
然后第三节，这个作者，这个希伯来作者呢，就指出了我们真的信，就知道世界是神的话造成的。
And what we say by faith, we understand that the universe was formed with God's command, so that what is seen was not made out of what was visible.
这里圣经是提出整个宇宙形成，没有任何人知道说到底是怎么来的。
So he is telling us the whole universe, how it operates, how it functions, nobody really knows about. But then we see the vastness of the universe existence. We know that the universe is created by the word of God. So the beginning of the universe, we must see it with the eyes of faith. So verse 4,
一提到古人，作者就先从这个的《创世纪》的亚伯和该隐说起了。So
when it talks about the ancient, it begins with Abel.
第四节说，亚伯因作献祭与神，比该隐所献的更美。By
faith, Abel offered God a better sacrifice than Cain did.
因此他得了称义的见证，就是神指着他礼物做的见证。他虽然死了，却因着信仍然说话。
By faith he was commended as a righteous man when God spoke well of his offering, and by faith he still speaks even though he is dead.
在创世纪的里面记载，没有详细解释为什么亚伯所献的祭蒙神喜悦，而该隐所献的祭不蒙神的悦纳。
From what is recorded in the book of Genesis, we are not very sure why the offering of Abel was more acceptable than that of Cain.
不过我们可以知道，亚伯献的祭是包括羊群中投生的和羊的子由。But
what we know that the offering of Abel is the firstborn of the sheep, and also the fat offering.
表示亚伯将自己最好的献上。It
means that Abel offered the best.
那如果你read创世纪经文这样说。
So if you were to read from this portion of the scripture,
耶和华看中了亚伯和他的公公，却拒绝了该隐和他的公公。
So Abel's offering was acceptable by God, and Cain was not acceptable by God.
因为该隐没有做正确的事。
Because Cain did not do the right thing.
这个经文记载在这个的创世纪第四章六到七节。
This is recorded in the books of Genesis chapter 4, verse 6 to 7.
耶和华对该隐说：“你为什么发怒呢？你为什么变了脸色呢？我不接受你的这个的奉献，这献祭，你为什么发怒？为什么变了脸色呢？”
So Yahweh said to Cain, "Why are you angry? The offering that you offer up is not acceptable."
第七节，他说：“若你行得好，必蒙岂不蒙悦纳？你若行得不好，罪就伏在你门前，他必。” 恋慕你，你却要制服他。
If you do what is right, will you not be accepted? But if you do, not what is right, sin is crouching on your door. It's desire to have you, but you must master it.
我们可以从神的这句话来明白。
So we can understand from this word.
奉献者或者是献祭，必须要做应该做的事。
So offering must be doing things that is right.
这一点是非常重要的。
So this is a very important point.
换句话说，如果一个人的奉献是从来自不应该得到的财物奉献的话，那个奉献是不浪费、不会让神所喜悦的。
If this offering is done by something that is not right, it's not acceptable unto God.
因为那样的奉献是会变成一种 亵渎神的一个奉献。
So this kind of offering become a blasphemous offering unto God.
因此亚伯得到神的悦纳的奉献，他的奉献得神的悦纳。
Therefore we see that the offering of Abel was acceptable by God.
而且亚伯死了这么久，他今天仍然说话。
Even though Abel has gone so many hundred, thousand of years, yet he is speaking to us today.
因为亚伯的态度和他行为，他得到神的喜悦。
Because Abel's attitude and action was acceptable by God.
所以使他的信心的榜样继续能够延迟下去，仍然向我们来说话。
So therefore, the example of faith continues to speak to us.
怎样的奉献才会赢得上帝的喜悦呢？
So what kind of offering will be acceptable to God?
有一个很基本的条件。
So here are a few simple conditions.
就是带着诚实与喜悦的心来奉献。
It must be a sincere and joyous offering.
所以你要的奉献是诚实的，是喜悦的。
So your offering and my offering should be sincere and joyous.
你的奉献将蒙神的喜悦。
Then such offering will be acceptable by God.
那讲完这个的亚伯和盖隐之后，希伯来书作者在讲这个第二个代表人物是这个的以诺。
So from Abel and Cain, we come to Enoch.
那么第五节说，以诺因着信被接去，不至于见死，人也找不着他，因为神已经把他接去了，只是他被接去以先，已经得了神喜悦他的名证。By
faith Noah was Enoch was taken from this life, so that he did not experience death. He could not be found because God has taken him away. For before he was taken, he was commended as one who pleased God.
如果你看圣经,
so if you were to look at the scripture,
你看到圣经中有两个记载两个人没有死呢，就被神接回去天上的。
It speaks of two persons who did not die on earth and they were transferred into heaven.
除了第一个就是以诺。
The first was Enoch.
另一个就是先知以利亚。
And the second was the prophet Elijah.
按照列王记下第二章十一节，先知以利亚是乘坐马车飞往天上去的。So
according to 2 Kings chapter 2 verse 11, Elijah was taken up by the fiery chariots.
他们正走着说话，复有火车、火马将两人隔开，以利亚就乘旋风升天去了。
And as they were walking along and talking together, suddenly a chariot of fire and horses of fire appeared and separated the two of them, and Elijah went up to heaven in a whirlwind.
所以以诺和以利亚是没经过死就被接回去的。So
Enoch and Elijah did not go through death, and they were taken up to heaven.
依照这个创世纪第五章21到23的记载，以诺共活了365岁。
So we know that Enoch, he lived until 365 years.
但是是创世第五章记载那些长寿的人当中呢，以诺的岁数是最短的一位。
So from the lifespan that is recorded in the book of Genesis, the life of Enoch on earth is the shortest.
因为那边写到有人活了600岁，有人700岁，800岁，900岁。
And some of the others, they live until 600 or 700 or even 800 years.
但是以诺才是365岁。
But Enoch lived on earth only 365 years.
虽然这样，作者的这个创世纪作者却说了一句形容以诺的话。
So he speaks something about Enoch here.
24节，创世纪15章第5章24节，以诺与神同行，神将他举去，他就不在世上了。
Genesis 5:24 say, Enoch walked with God, then he was no more, because God took him away.
以诺是一生与神同行。
So in his whole life, Enoch walked with God.
所以弟兄姐妹，这说明一件很重要的事情。
So here is something very important for us.
在世界上生命的时间呢，不用太长。
So our life on earth may not be long.
只要能够与上帝保持密切的关系，与神同行，这个就是生命最大的祝福了。
But the greatest blessing is that when you are able to walk well in relationship with God is the greatest blessing.
圣经在这边讲。 当以诺被神接去之前呢，他已经先得了神喜悦他的名证。
So before Enoch was taken up to heaven, he was commended as one who pleased God.
因为他有信心，他的信心在神面前得了神的喜悦。
Because of his faith, he was pleased by God.
再接下来第七节，讲到这个挪亚的信心了。
And then what's happened about the faith of Noah?
挪亚那个信，既蒙神指示他未见的事，动了敬畏的心，预备了一只方舟，使他全家得救，因此就定了那时代的罪，自己也承受了那重新而来的义。
By faith, Noah, when warned about things not yet seen, in holy fear built an ark to save his family. By faith, he condemned the world and became heir to the righteousness that comes by faith.
我相信挪亚的故事大家都很熟了，对吗？
So I believe we are very familiar with the story of Noah.
就是有关于挪亚制造方舟和洪水的故事。我相信现在记载在这个创世纪第6章和第9章，相信大家都很熟了。
It's about Noah and his family building the ark, and then came the flood. I think we are familiar with this story.
Noah 在那个时代制造方舟。
So Noah during his time he built an ark.
我想当时他应该是被人众人取笑、羞辱，在那边的来笑他。
And I believe that time many people sneered and humiliated him.
因为每个人都不相信洪水会来。
And many people would not believe that the flood would come.
那么这个大好的日子里面。 为什么有这种制造方舟的怪异的行为呢？
So in such a good time, why is there a very strange thing that someone is building an ark?
但创世纪作者却描述挪亚只做一件事，就是照做上帝的吩咐，他一一的都做了。
So the writer of the book of Genesis says Noah did one thing, that is to do something according to what God tell him.
虽然他不知道洪水什么时候会来，但是神要他做的事，他做了。
Even though he don't know when the heavy rain will come, but whatever God asked him to do, he did it.
创世纪6章22节说，挪亚就这样行，凡神所吩咐的，他就照样行了。
So Genesis 6:22 say Noah did just as God commanded him.
弟兄姐妹
，brothers and sisters，
照着上帝话去行，这个在一个非常败坏、非常邪恶的时代，在创世纪的时候是很难的。
So to do something in obedience unto God in this crooked generation during the time of Noah is something very difficult.
一个要确实遵循上帝话去行事，这在这样的时代，需要有很大信心才能做的。So
someone who is going to obey God in the wicked generation, he must have great faith to do it.
为什么挪亚能够做呢？
Why is it Noah able to do it?
因为圣经告诉我们说，挪亚是在那个时代中，他是唯一的一个义人，他与神同行。
So it tells us Noah at that time he was the only righteous man and he walked with God.
这个在创世纪6章第9节说，挪亚的后代记在下面，挪亚是个义人，在当时时代是个完全人，挪亚与神同行。
It's recorded in Genesis 6:9. This is the account Noah. Noah was a righteous man, blameless among the people of his time, and he walked with God.
就只有这样有信心的人才能够做到这样的事。
So it's only those who have faith. He is able to do such a thing.
然后来到希伯来书第8节到第19节这一段。
So coming to Hebrews chapter 8, verses 8 to 19.
这个就是讲到有关于亚伯拉罕的故事了。
It speaks of the story of Abraham.
如果你看创世纪从12章开始一直到25章，都是讲论有关于亚伯拉罕的各种的事情。
So from Genesis chapter 12 to 19, it talks about the account of Abraham.
其中一个最出名的一件事。
So a very important thing is.
就是记载在创世纪22章有关亚伯拉罕把自己唯一的儿子以撒献给上帝的那件事。
It's in Genesis 22 about how Abraham sacrificed his son.
在这件事上，亚伯拉罕并毫无保留的愿意将以撒献上为祭。
So Abraham offered up his son Isaac.
这样的信心使神大大的感动。So
such a faith was really acceptable by God.
然后神只作自己的名字向亚伯拉罕讲，只作自己的名字发誓向亚伯拉罕讲说。So
God, according to his name, said to Abraham.
在创世纪22章16到18节。
It's in Genesis chapter 22:16-18.
耶和华说。 你亚伯拉罕既然行了这事，不留下你的孙子儿子，就是你独生的儿子，我便只做自己发誓说
，I swear by myself, declares the Lord, that because you have done this and have not withheld your son, your only son，
论到父，我必赐与你大父给你；论到子孙，我必叫你的子孙多起来，如同天上星，海边的沙。你子孙必得着仇敌的城门。
And according to what you are doing。 You will be blessed by the stars in the skies, the her descendants, as well as like the sand in the seashore, for her descendants will take possession of the city of the enemies. And all nations will be blessed by your offspring because you obey me.
这个就是希伯来书第八节到十九节所要强调的一个信心的内涵。So
this is from Hebrews verses 8 to 19.
那么第八节亚伯拉罕因着信蒙召的时候就遵命就去，将往将来要得为业的地方去。出去的时候还不知道自己要往哪里去。By
faith Abraham, when called to go to a place he would later receive as his inheritance, obey and went, even though he didn't know where he was going.
第九节，他因着信就在所应许的之地做客，好像在异地居住帐篷，与那同盟一个应许的以撒雅各一样。
Verse 9, by faith he made his home in a promised land, a stranger in a foreign country. He lived in tents as did Isaac and Jacob, who were heirs with him of the same promise.
因为他等候那座有根基的城，就是神所经营所建造的。
For he was looking forward to the city of foundations, whose architect and builder is God.
弟兄们，在希伯来书第十一章八到十节这段经文里面。
So brothers and sisters, in 11 verses 8 to 10,
作者就提到了亚伯拉罕、以撒和雅各，其实这三个人呢是这个的祖孙三个人。
So it tells us about Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, is a from the grandfather to the father to the grandson.
亚伯拉罕、以撒、雅各，他们都没有定居的居所。
So they do not have a permanent place.
虽然上帝都一而再再而三地告诉他们说，将会赐赏他们有大片的土地可以居住。
Even though God had told them many times, you will be given a vast land to reside.
并且他们可以成为大国。
And you will become a great nation.
可是这三个人在他们有生之年，他们还是居住在帐篷里，四处搬迁游荡。
And these three of them during a lifetime, they were shifting here and there, they were wandering.
就是这样的遭遇以及状况，他们这个祖孙三人亚伯拉罕、以撒、雅各还是一样。
So these three from the grandfather. Father and grandson they were in such a situation.
但是他们从来没有对上帝有过失望，或者是失去的信心。But
they did not lose their faith in God.
即使这个像雅各，遇到最疼爱的儿子约瑟被他的其他儿子欺骗说约瑟死在这个野兽的攻击之下，雅各在悲伤之余也没有离弃上帝。And
even though Jacob he lost his son, Joseph. The other son told him that he was eaten by the one animal he did not lose faith.
十一节。Verse 11。依旧信，撒拉自己虽然过了生育的岁数，还能怀孕，因为以为他那应许他的是可信的。By
faith Abraham, even though he was past age and Sarah herself was barren, was unable to become a father because he considered himself faithful. Who had made the promise.
而且，所以从一个患过已死的人生出子孙，如同天上星那么众多，海边的沙那样无数。
Verse 12, and so from this one man, as good as dead, came descendants as numerous as the stars in the sky, and as countless as the sand on the seashore.
弟兄们，如果你以希伯来书第十一章十一节和这个创世纪十八章的记载呢，你开始的时候，撒拉并不相信自己还能够怀孕的。
So from Hebrews chapter 11, verse 11, and then from Genesis chapter 18, you realize that Sarah did not believe.
撒拉甚至躲在帐篷里面后面那边偷笑。
And Sarah was behind the tent and she was laughing.
认为天使与亚伯拉罕所说她会怀孕生子的事，她简直就是认为那是不可理事意的事情。
So as the angels were talking to Abraham. She said that it's something impossible.
为什么呢?
Why is it so?
你看到撒拉自言自语的时候，这样说十一节。
So Sarah was saying to herself.
亚伯拉罕和撒拉的年纪老迈，撒拉的月经